Queensland Cabinet to discuss COVID-19 vaccine rollout as coronavirus fragments detected at 13 wastewater sites in 48 hours. Virus fragments found at 7 more Queensland wastewater treatment plants. Now, both of these news stories were from yesterday, Australia Day, 26th of January 2021. About 3 weeks ago, on the 5th of January, COVID-19 fragments found in Queensland wastewater from Cairns to Logan Home. So this has been going on for a while now. But hang on, if we go back a further 6 weeks, so 9 weeks ago from today, 25th of November 2020, coronavirus traces found in Queensland wastewater as state prepares to reopen. People who have recovered from COVID-19 can have live or dead virus in their stool for weeks after recovery. But wait, there's more. On the 3rd of September last year, so like 21 weeks ago, fever clinic set up in Airlie Beach after COVID-19 detected in sewerage. If we plot all these positive wastewater locations on a map, Airlie Beach, Cairns, Hervey Bay, Warwick, Stanthorpe, Logan, Townsville, Nambour, Maroochydore, Yeppoon, Caboolture, Brisbane, Ipswich, Rockhampton, Mackay, and the Gold Coast. Okay, so pretty much everywhere that has a sewerage system has coronavirus fragments. So what's going on here? Well, if we look at the Queensland Government's COVID statistics, there were zero new cases, only 1,305 cases in total, 1.7 million tests, and 6 deaths. So what does this mean? Why are all these sewerage facilities testing positive to coronavirus? According to Queensland's Chief Health Officer, Dr. Jeanette Young, while this does not mean we have new cases of COVID-19 in these communities, we are treating these detections seriously. A positive sewerage result means that someone who has been infected was shedding the virus. Infected people can shed viral fragments, and that shedding can happen for several weeks after the person is no longer infectious. Now, this has been going on for months, but yet nobody in Queensland is testing positive to the illness. What does that mean? Well, I think there are only two possible explanations. Either one, the sewerage tests are faulty, they're coming back with false readings, but I think this would be unlikely. I assume that the Queensland Government would not publish this data unless they were 100% sure it was correct. I'm sure they have double-checked and triple-checked every test. They have probably taken multiple samples just to make sure. So I guess we can rule out this one. According to the tests, there is coronavirus in the sewerage. So where does that leave us? Well, I think the only other possibility is that there is coronavirus in the community, and there has been for a long time. How else can we explain all this contaminated sewerage over the last few months? But I don't think this is cause for alarm. We can just look at the statistics. Nobody is dying or even testing positive for the virus. How can we explain that? Well, the only thing that I can think of is that people who are getting this virus are simply not getting sick. Well, not sick enough to warrant going to the doctor or a hospital to get tested. Let's face it, if you did go to the hospital with even the most minor of symptoms, they would test you. But that's not what we're seeing. Nobody is testing positive for the virus. Lots of sewage is testing positive, but not people. I would hazard a guess that if they tested everybody in Queensland, they would probably find hundreds of people, if not thousands of people, with the virus. But nobody is sick. Nobody is dying. The only way they can prove this virus exists is by testing people's excrement. Now, if they did test the entire population and found thousands of cases, you can guarantee that all hell would break loose. It would be all over the media, with lockdowns and masks coming back into effect. This just goes to show you that it's the media and the government that makes this pandemic scary, not the actual virus. I mean, what else can it be? If there's all these coronavirus fragments being found in sewerage all across Queensland, then surely that means that normal people are carrying the virus without ill effect. Dr. Young has made public comments that suggest that she at least somewhat thinks that there is virus in the community. She said, "If there is a case we are not yet aware of, it is critical we detect it through our testing mechanisms as quickly as possible to contain any potential spread." Well, sorry, Doctor, too late. Just look at the map. It's already here and has been here for months. It's all over the place. How else can we explain all these positive wastewater results? But obviously, she doesn't want to use the same line of thinking that I'm using. She wants to believe that the coronavirus can exist in sewerage, but somehow that doesn't equate to thousands of people having the virus. University of Queensland professor Kevin Thomas, an expert in monitoring of wastewater for illicit substances, tried to explain this somewhat. He said, "If we detect fragments of the virus in an area where there are no known positive cases, then there is someone in that catchment who is shedding the virus. We're confident in the technology. There are a range of different reasons the virus could be there. It could have been from a person who has recovered from the virus but is still shedding virus particles. It could be an undetected case." Okay, there we go. The only possible explanation, according to the expert in wastewater monitoring, is that there are people with the virus. Either they had the virus and have since recovered, or they currently have the virus. And looking at this map, the virus is everywhere. It's potentially been here for months. But as I said, nobody is dying and nobody is becoming sick. Well, not sick enough to warrant going and getting tested. That's the only possible explanation. Another further explanation posited by Professor Thomas is the simple measures such as social distancing that these communities are taking. He said, "What it's telling us when we see these signals in these catchments is that these precautions that communities are being recommended to do in the fight against COVID are working, because there aren't flare-ups in these areas." Well, I'd just like to call him out on that one. I've travelled to multiple cities in Queensland over the last couple of months, and I have not seen any social distancing, except during the recent 3-day lockdown in Brisbane. Every shopping centre I went to, there were thousands of people pretty much not social distancing. Maybe people were using hand sanitizer more often. But certainly, if there was a virus spreading around, lots of people would definitely have it. And according to this map, lots of people do have it. It's just that nobody is dying or going to hospital. And Queenslanders are doing just fine. In other news, Australia has suspended the New Zealand travel bubble over a single case of COVID. Is that all it takes to call off international travel? A single case? Well, yes, apparently so. Also, the Pfizer vaccine has been approved for use in Australia and is expected to be rolled out late February. Prime Minister Scott Morrison expects all Australians over the age of 16 to be fully vaccinated by October. Well, sorry to say, Prime Minister, but you haven't taken into account that some people just won't take the vaccine. And as you said, you're not going to force anybody to get it, right? So what do you think? Is all of this contaminated sewage something to worry about? Are you going to stop swimming in wastewater because of it? Or are you just going to get on with your life and learn to stop living in a constant state of media-induced fear?